our second hot copy, the Philippines rejects calls from a United Nations body to legalize same-sex marriage and enact other pieces of legislation that seek to protect the members of the LGBT community from discrimination and allow divorce in the country. The recommendation was made during the Universal Periodic Review of the UN Human Rights Council in Geneva last week. Joining us now for more on this, we have Bataan Representative Geraldine Roman. Good morning, Congresswoman, and thank you so much for joining Head Start.
Good morning, Rica. It's a pleasure to be with you. Good morning from Cambodia, where we are attending the ASEAN Interparliamentary Assembly.
All right. Thank you so much for taking time for us, Congresswoman. It's going to be a long day ahead of you. Let's move on now to the topic. Let's jump straight to it. The UN body has given us a number of recommendations, actually, but the Philippine delegation accepted just about 200 plus of the suggestions that they gave us, especially more particularly the sensitive topics they tried to veer away from. The Philippines, we've been a predominantly Catholic country. That's the excuse, actually, that Secretary de Mulla has been saying for the Philippines to delve deeper into sensitive issues like divorce, same-sex marriage, the LGBTQ rights here in the Philippines. But actually, the Philippines is a secular state. So we shouldn't be putting too much importance on one religion. I'd like to get your thoughts on this, Congresswoman.
That is true. We are a secular state where there is separation between church and state. And we lawmakers in the Congress and in the Senate know that we cannot legislate in favor of any religion in particular. Mm-hmm. What we can do is to try to come to a compromise and also respect the sensibilities of the different religions in our country. But first and foremost should be the welfare of our citizens, whether they are straight or LGBTQ, whether they are married or divorced. As long as you're a Filipino citizen, your welfare is our duty to protect.
Mm-hmm. We've been trying to fight the good fight for the LGBTQ community. It's been your advocate since you started running for politics. Right now, Congresswoman, there's no anti-discriminatory legislation when it comes, when we talk about national levels. We do have some for the local levels, some ordinances on the local levels. But how do we strengthen local efforts sans national support?
Well, you know what? This is the irony of ironies. Actually, Secretary Justin Mulli of the Department of Justice was the one who communicated, his rejection on behalf of the country of progressive measures such as marriage equality, as well as the anti-discrimination bill based on sexual orientation and gender identity and expression, which is locally known as the SOGI Equality Bill, as well as the divorce bill here in the Philippines. But of course, we all know that Secretary Remulla is part of the executive and he is not a policymaker as of the moment. Mm. So it is up for us in Congress to decide whether we are to approve any legislative measure in that direction. To cite an example, for example, in the lower house, former Speaker Pantaleon Alvarez has filed a bill that seeks to recognize civil unions, not marriages, but civil unions. Also, there are several congressmen, including myself, who have filed our own versions of the SOGI Equality Bill or the Anti-Discrimination Bill. You know, I was reading the article on Secretary Remulla's pronouncements in Geneva, where he supposedly and reportedly rejected the calls made by the United Nations to pass legislation in favor of the LGBT plus also the divorce bill here in the Philippines. But what's funny is that I know Secretary Remulla, he comes from Cavite province, where there is an anti-discrimination ordinance in place. And it's quite ironic. If he wants it in Cavite, why shouldn't he want it?
Why not for the national scale?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So I also read that he said that same-sex marriage was part of the anti-discrimination bill. And this is not true. I invite the good secretary to read the SOGI Equality Bill and discover what it truly is. It is simply an anti-discrimination bill that ensures that all Filipinos should have access to work, to study, to services from the government, to use public accommodations, access public facilities without discrimination based on their sexual orientation and gender identity and expression. It has no provision on same-sex marriage. Sa madaling salita po, wala kayong makikita ang same-sex marriage dyan po sa loob ng SOGIE Equality Bill. Palagi ko po, dapat basahin ng mga manunood natin ngayon, pati na rin po ng ating mahal na Secretary ng Justice, Jess Romulia, ang nilalaman ng SOGIE Equality Bill. At ito po ay halos kapareho ng Anti-Discrimination Bill na naisabatas na po nila sa kanilang home province ng Cavite, sa ilalim po ng kanyang kapatid na si Governor John Vic Renulla. At pinasasalamatan ko po si Senator Governor John Vic Renulla dahil sa ordinansang ito. At ako'y naniniwala, pag nabasa ni Secretary Renulla ang SOGIE Equality Bill, ay sasang-ayon din siya sapagkat ito po ay sinang-ayonan din nila sa kanilang kapatid.
Do you think, Congresswoman, that the good secretary may not be as open to the idea of this as his brother is?
Well, sa mga magkakapatid, meron ding pagkakaiba ng punto de vista. Pero siya po ay isang Kabiteño. At nalalaman niya na sa Cavite, hindi naman po bumabagsak ang langit dahil sila ay nakapagpasa ng isang anti-discrimination ordinance. Kung lahat naman Caviteño at Cavitena ay napoprotektahan at wala pong miyembro ng LGBTQ community, ang theoretically ang maaaring i-discriminate sa lalawigan ng Cavite, katulad na rin po sa lalawigan ng Bataan. So which begs the question, if we are willing to pass anti-discrimination ordinances in the different provinces in our country, why aren't we willing to pass it on a nationwide scale? Hindi pa naman po bumabagsak ang langit sa mga lalawigan at sa mga syudad, sa mga bayan kung saan mayroong anti-discrimination ordinance. So, konting pagbubukas lang po ng loob ng pag-iisip at ng puso ang kailangan natin.
On the same issue, Congresswoman, before we jump into a different topic altogether, the SOGIE Equality Bill, hindi po siya nag-push through on the 18th Congress, but we're trying to at least sponsor it now. What's the current status on the bill, Congresswoman?
Well, we just started our organizational meeting of the Committee on Women and Gender Equality, which I head, by the way. I am the chairperson of the Committee on Women and Gender Equality. It is one of our many priorities. Mm-hmm. In fact, it is one of the priorities identified by the Philippine Commission on Women. It's been long overdue. It's been 22 years since it was first filed. So what are we waiting for? Naalala ko noong 17th Congress, naipasa po namin sa lower house. Noong 18th Congress, medyo nagkagulo po ang ating bansa, like many countries around the world because of the COVID-19 pandemic. So this time, I think we have no other excuse not to pass it. It is ripe already for passage.
Another contentious law, Congresswoman, the divorce law, the divorce bill, actually, it's still a bill here in the Philippines. Aside from the Vatican, the Philippines is the only other country in the whole world that doesn't have the divorce law yet in place. And the Secretary Renulla said that this needs to be thoroughly discussed.
I agree with him.
Your thoughts on this, please.
It has to be thoroughly discussed in Congress, which is the proper venue. We in Congress, this is the way we work. We consult with the different stakeholders. We hear them out. But of course, with a clear reminder to all of us legislators that the basis of our laws is the Constitution. And part of this is part of our duty is to ensure the welfare and happiness of all Filipino citizens. Alam nyo, the divorce bill was first filed many, many years ago already, many Congresses ago. And one of the foremost champions is Representative Ed Selegman. I also remember in the 17th Congress, I worked closely with now Senator Pia Ontiveros to push for the passage of the divorce bill. At pag nabasa nyo po yung dissolution of marriage bill na yan, there is nothing there that will oblige any Filipino to file for divorce. Sa madalit salita, kung ayaw mo mag-divorce, then by all means, you keep your marriage, you stay in your marriage. Good for you, I'm happy for you. But for those Filipinos who are stuck in toxic marriages, who are victims of domestic abuse, of violence, emotional abuse, physical abuse, who have no hope but dissolution of marriage, then we should open our minds and pass this bill.
Mm-hmm. Because you already have the annulment in place here in the country, why not then why are we still dragging on the talks about divorce?
Because annulment is a long, tedious, and expensive process. Kung mag-a-afford lang yan ng mga mayayaman na merong kakayahang magbayad ng isang mabuting abogado. At kapag annulment, dapat medyo confrontational, adversarial. Nag-aaway dapat yung husband and wife. Eh what if naman, maganda naman ang pag-uusap ng husband and wife? What if they agreed na, hey, hindi na po pwede itong relationship
natin. Amicable splits, yes.
Amicable separation. Hindi na po pwede. At kinakailangan natin harapin ang katotohanan that it will not survive. Mauwi lang to sa madalas na pag-aaway and possibly physical violence. We should consider the possibility of divorce to allow them a second chance of happiness. Alam mo, ang tawag ko dito, Rica, sa divorce bill is a second chances bill. Everybody deserves to be happy in life. We only have one life to live. Might as well live it in a happy manner. Now, hindi ko na po papasukin kung ano yung mga religious doctrines ng isa't isa, no? Kung ikaw ay Katoliko and you strongly believe in the indissolubility of marriage, then by all means, fight it out. Pero there are those who are non-Catholic, di ba? Who belong to other religions who may not believe in this. Or there are Catholics who are stuck in toxic relationships. Bakit natin sila pipigilan? But anyway, reminder yan po, this is just a purely legal formula. Hindi natin panghihimasukan yung mga proseso sa loob ng simbahang Katolika o kahit anumang relihiyon. I know for a fact that even in Islam, there is a divorce process, separation process. Ganun din ang Iglesia Katolika. Meron din siyang annulment, no? Process. But medyo mahabang proseso yan, medyo mahal. At we should also provide a legal remedy.
All right, and let's end this on a good note, Congresswoman. It's a pleasure talking to you. Have a good long day ahead, Congresswoman. You're going to be there for a whole week. Thank you so much for your time, ma'am. Good morning.
Medyo malungkot ako, Rica, dahil sa pangyayari sa Colorado.
Yes, the LGBTQ shooting.
LGBT community shooting. Kung sa Estados Unidos nga, kung saan meron mga batas pabor sa LGBTQ nangyayari ito, ano pa kaya sa ating bansa? Meron pong pangangailangang ipasa ang Anti-Discrimination Bill or SOG Equality Bill. Buksan po natin ang ating mga isipan at puso at alalahanin na kapapilipino sila, tao sila, na may karapatan tulad mo at tulad ko. Thank you very much, Rica.
Thank you, Congresswoman Geraldine Roman, our representative from Bataan.